Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of Karvi Stockbroking Limited, I welcome you all for Q3FY18 earnings conference call of Nandan Denim Ltd. Today, we have with us the senior management of the company represented by Mr. Ashok Bothra, Chief Financial Officer, and Ms. Purvi Roy, the company secretary. I now request Mr. Ashok Bothra to give his opening remarks. Thank you and over to you, sir.
Good afternoon. Hello.
Yes, I can hear you. You may go ahead.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Greetings and a very warm welcome to everyone present here for the earnings call of Nandan Denim Limited to discuss the performance during the third quarter of the financial year FY18. We recorded robust financial performance this quarter and registered significant improvement both on the turnover and margin fronts. And our 9-month revenue in this financial year has nearly reached the FY17 level, which places us in a commanding position to deliver higher turnover growth on a full year basis. Coming to our Q3 financial performance, our revenue from operation substantially increased by 55% Y-on-Y basis from 235 to 363 crores. Denim fabric sale increased by 13% Y-o-Y basis from 203 crore to 230 crore. Shirting fabric sales increased from 17 crore to 28 crore. Our denim relation per meter for full 9-month period is 135 rupee per meter, registering a 3% increment over FY17 relation. Similarly, our 9-month FY18 shirting relation improved by 7% on Y basis. Growth profit margin stands at 32.8% for the quarter and has improved on Y-on-Y basis by 198 bips, but remained flat on Q-on-Q basis. EBITDA margin this quarter has gone up by 3% Y-o-Y basis and 1.17% on Q-on-Q basis. That is to 16.5%. Depreciation increased to 30 crore from 17 crore because of the expanded capacity, but is in line with the quarterly run rate. Finance cost increased to 13.7 crore from 6 crore Y-on-Y basis. The reason for increase is, because in the past in the Q3FY17 project was under installation and interest got capitalized to the extent applicable. And the QOQ reduction interest expenses is led to debt repayment of around 15 crore in the previous quarter, apart from interest rate reduction also. We recorded 63% growth in our PAT on Y basis, which stands at 13.7 crores. The PAT margin is flat both on the Y and Q-on-Q basis. The demand scenario is expected to pick up from the first quarter of next financial year, and by then we will start witnessing higher capacity utilization level. With this, I would like now to hand over the call for further question and answer section.
Sure, thank you very much. We will now begin with the question and answer session. Participants who wish to ask questions may press star and one on their touchtone telephone. If you wish to remove yourself from the question queue, you may press star and two. Participants are requested to use handsets while asking questions. Ladies and gentlemen, we will wait for a moment while the question queue assembles. We have the first question from the line of Abhishek Maheshwari from Walford Portfolio.
Yes, sir. Thank you for the opportunity. Sir, a couple of questions. My first question is regarding your denim realizations. They are 135 per meter on net level or gross level?
Gross level.
Okay, gross. And the GST is?
GST is around 5%, but that was not there pre-GST era.
Okay, this is net of GST.
Gross of GST, sir.
Okay.
If I includes around 8 rupees.
Okay.
Of GST.
This 135 includes 8 rupees of GST. Okay. And sir, my second question is regarding your utilization level. on Q-on-Q basis, your utilization levels have decreased considerably. So in Q4, can we expect a slight uptick here, or can we expect only 75%?
Q3, Diwali falls, in Q3, and which is, subdued period for the fabric manufacturer. So this is industry trend only, but otherwise there is no significant fall in the sale.
Okay, so we can expect a slight uptick in Q4.
Slight uptick in Q4, but markets are slightly subdued.
Okay.
Maybe because of GST impact is still not over 100%. But we expect the market to revive by the end of, say, March or so.
Okay. Okay, so, sir, my last question is regarding your cotton market. What's that like nowadays? Because cotton prices have not fallen as we expected because of pest attacks and all. So, how do you see that situation?
Cotton price, if you compare with the last year, it is on the lower side. In the December or Jan previous year, the prices were anywhere between 42,000 to 44,000, which whereas as of now the cotton price is around 40,000 to 41,000, 40,500 to very precise, 40,500 to 41,500. So there is a declining trend.
Okay.
To previous year.
Okay. And sir, this last question, sir, this the news articles and every industry experts, they say that there is globally overcapacity of denim fabric. So do we see any import risk in coming years, or do you think you are quite sustainable in domestic markets?
If you see, Indian denim industry is quite competitive, as mainly because of the availability of raw material, quality raw material available in abundance, availability of skilled manpower, availability of the state-of-the-art machinery. So per se, I don't perceive any import threat as such.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Sumrat Singh, who's an individual investor. Please go ahead.
My question is regarding the capacity utilization. What is your current capacity utilization, sir?
It's around 75, anywhere between 75% to 80%.
75% and 80%.
75% to 80%. Maybe 76%, 77%. To be very precise.
Okay, sir. One more question regarding the debt repayment. You already said that you have interest rate has been decreased. So that means you have refinanced your term loan from one financial institution to other. So how much is that impact?
No, I mean to say we have negotiated with the existing banker to get the interest rate reduced. We are not went for take over the loan.
And what is the repayment that you have done during this 9 month period, sir?
Around 45 crore, sir.
45 crore. And the same is for the next year?
Annual repayment will be around 60 crore, sir. We are talking about for 9 months, so we have repaid.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Ojasvi Agarwal from India Capital.
Hello, sir. Yes, sir. Sir, I wanted to know about the past subsidy benefit and the interest subsidy that we're expecting an approval in quarter four, in principle approval. So how does that come, sir?
Ma'am, I did not get you. Can you repeat your question, ma'am?
Yes, sir. Sir, I was saying that in the last con call, you had mentioned about your interest subsidy in principle approval from TAF. So how does that come through?
No, yeah. We have already applied to the state machinery.
Yes,
and has been carried out. So it is under process. When the next meeting will happen, so it will be taken up by the state government.
Okay. And so what about the power subsidy? That also?
Yeah, yeah. Power and interest and so it will be simultaneously taken up in the same meeting.
Okay. And sir, could you give us a guidance for financial year 19, the EBITDA margin that you're looking at for the entire year?
Right now, I am not in a position to quantify the, you know, EBITDA margins or PAT margin, but definitely I see my view will be, you know, revival of the market, whether it is sale, turnover, or profit margins.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. That will be all from my side.
Thank you. Before we take the next question, we'd like to remind participants that you may press star and one to join the question queue. The next question is from the line of Anirban Bhattacharya from Alpha Alternatives.
Hi, sir. I just wanted to ask you about the price realization for this quarter.
Price realization is around 135 rupee, 133 for this quarter.
For the quarter, okay. And the next question would be, how is the power and fuel cost come up, like quarter-on-quarter, year-on-year? What has that been?
Hello?
Hello? What is the power and fuel cost?
Roughly around 7% of the sales, roughly.
Okay. So, like, has it increased or decreased, like, year-on-year, quarter-on-quarter? Hello. Hello.
Participants, please stay connected. We seem to have lost the line for the management.
Hello.
Hello.
Yes, we can hear you now, sir. Please go ahead.
Hi, Anirvan here, sir.
Depends on the condition of the machinery, how many days, how many shifts you have run the plant.
Hello?
Huh?
Yeah, that's it.
Thank you. Before we take the next question, another reminder to our participants that you may press star and one to join the question queue. Our next question is from the line of Deep Walia, who's an individual investor. Please go ahead. Mr. Deep Walia, you may go ahead with your question. Mr. Deep Walia? There seems to be no response from the line of Deep Walia. We'll move to the next question. The next question is from the line of Abhishek Maheshwari from Walford Portfolio.
Yes, sir. I have a follow-up question. Sir, you have a spinning capacity of 141 ton per day. So are we operating that at full capacity or utilizations for that have reduced?
Question is, you know, around 80 to 85% for our spinning basically.
Okay.
But whatsoever we can consume in our in-house, we consume. Otherwise, we say, try to sell out in the outside market, depending on the demands, demand and.
Margin outlook you cannot give, right? So, thank you. That's it from my side.
Thank you. Participants who wish to ask questions, please press star and one on your touchtone telephone. Next question is from the line of Deep Walia, who's an individual investor. Please go ahead.
Hello?
Yes, please go ahead, Mr. Walia.
Okay, sorry. My name is Nandan Denim Ltd, so I think you got my name wrong. Anyway, sir, the question for you was, there is oversupply in the denim market in India as well. So can you give your comments on that as well? Is that easing out? Are there any new capacities coming up domestically?
Actually, if you see, Gujarat supply around 65 to 70% of total denim production in India. And state subsidy was policy was supposed to expire on 4th September 2017. In anticipation of that, you know, people advance their expansion. So there is temporary mismatch in the denim demand and the consumption, basically demand and supply. So, but going forward, since population is growing, and because of more urbanization and migration of people from village to city, will definitely correct this.
So what is the gap between the demand and supply right now?
People, you know, most of the manufacturers are operating anywhere between 60% to 80%. Like our case, we are operating at 80%. So there is enough scope for increasing the capacity utilization.
Okay. Are there, would you be aware if there are new capacities in the industry coming up, or people are just looking to improve the utilization right now?
As I told, this Gujarat is a major hub of denim production. So, whosoever was having the expansion plan, they already put up their plant. So, and because of the supply exceeding demand, so I don't foresee, you know, any player is, you know, putting a major plant for denim manufacturing.
Okay, can you give an outlook in terms of top line for next year? I heard you, margin would be difficult, but any outlook in terms of top line?
So everything depends on the demand. So if demand will revive, definitely our top line will also grow. But if you see our past track, we are growing at a CAGR around 15%.
Yeah.
So, and with the GDP growth around 7%, so you can, you know, take a clue from that.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. Participants who wish to ask questions at this time, please press star and one. Anyone else who wishes to ask a question may press star and one. As there are no further questions, I'd like to hand the conference back to the management for closing comments. Ms. Roy?
Yes, yeah, thank you everyone, and we look forward to connecting with you again in the next quarter.
Thank you very much. On behalf